Why did people migrate north to Britain? Why are there migration routes from the Mediterranean to more northern climates? Could it be that something radiating in the sky was too intense radiating from a southward direction that it forced people in the opposite direction? We see bunker-style houses on Easter Island that look eerily similar to the ones on Orkney, as if the people who were building these thick stone buildings were trying to protect themselves from more than just the wind, and maybe the answers to why they migrated north can be found in the Squatterman question. Wait till you hear this. Sychara Brae on Orkney is considered the best preserved Neolithic settlement in Western Europe, with people first making their homes there around 3100 BC. It was discovered in 1850 when a storm exposed part of the coastal site. Now, almost 170 years later, coastal erosion may have uncovered its neighbor. Reporting in the Scotsman, a section of badly damaged wall was exposed by the work of the pounding tides at the north end of the Bay of Scale. Deer antlers, a boar tooth, a cattle jawbone, and a large decorated stone have also been discovered. A spokesman for the Archaeology Institute at University of Highlands and Islands said the finds suggest there is another settlement at the Bay of Scale, one that, from previous environmental samplings, is likely to be 4,000 to 5,000 years old. And if this is the case, and based on the scale of the eroded section, we may well be looking at a Neolithic Bronze Age site on par with Sychara Brae, albeit one that is now disappearing at an alarming rate. The large decorated stone was discovered in the Bay of Scale after animal remains were discovered falling from an eroding section of shoreline. Closer inspection found the stone marked with a pair of incised triangles and a series of rectangular bands running across the surface. Dr. Antonia Thomas, the Archaeology Institute's rock art specialist, confirmed the find was potentially a carved stone, one with designs similar to those recorded at Sychara Brae. It has long been thought that more Neolithic settlements may have dotted the bay surrounding Sychara Brae. During building work in the 1930s, a wall was discovered to the north of the bay, along with trash material, animal bone, and four burials, which were later moved. The new finds have refreshed interest in who may have lived around the bay during the New Stone Age. The discovery of deer remains is an unusual find for a Neolithic site on Orkney. With the animal perhaps used for rituals rather than food, it is understood. The bay is now under close observations from the Archaeology Institute. Although an excavation is unlikely in the near future, given restrictions imposed by the current health crisis sweeping the globe. The Highlands and Islands Archaeology Institute will continue to carefully monitor the extent of the coastal erosion and act when necessary. Sychara Brae is considered the best preserved prehistoric settlement of any period in British Isles. Its preservation in sand has left a vivid impression of life in a prehistoric village. An exceptional collection of artifacts recovered from the site tell a story of farming and fishing among its inhabitants, as well as jewelry making and crafts. Artifacts including strange little carved balls, one example of the balls was found in Aberdeenshire, and shows a striking resemblance to the carvings at the site at Newgrange in Ireland. These are representative of the auroras manifesting discreetly in the sky, possibly the reason for the migration of culture to the most habitable northern points, accessible to the people, but what do you guys think about this anyway? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.